It's interesting. I feel like all of this, the past like 2 years in particular, have really been necessary in order to strengthen my intuition. Like, I feel like if I didn't have experiences where people were like, I hate what you're doing, or like, you should change it a little bit like this, then I wouldn't have the strength or like knowledge or courage, I guess, to be like, no, you know what, I kind of like what I'm doing.
I mean, it's like, it's hard to say no to hundreds of thousands of dollars when you like can barely afford toilet paper.
Louis and I had just finished up some time in DC together where we were writing a lot. And I don't know, we didn't know what we were gonna do with our music. I also hadn't been singing for a long time, so I was kind of rusty. I really wanted to like take some time for myself. And I moved to Brooklyn. It was $300 a month. It was this like dingy basement. It was so bad. I was pretty sick the whole time living there too.
I was a jazz studies an international affairs concentration double major at GW. And for my senior thesis, I was like, man, I want to record these songs that we wrote together and make them sound amazing. I knew the engineer, I knew the studio, I knew all the players to help us out. I wound up just having to spend all my savings on it. So I went broke in the process doing it.
A year and like 2 months ago, we were offered our first deal, and that was the one where they were like, we love you. Daft Punk had just like come up with their new stuff, which was awesome. And they're like, we love you, but we really want you to be a combination of Daft Punk and Iconopop. And it was like, okay, cool. That sounds like a cool band, but like, how can you literally say that to us? That's so crazy. And that was really interesting to me because, I mean, it really makes you question. It's like, oh, is what I'm doing not good enough then?
My parents were like, are you sure you're like, you want to do this? Maybe you should take the money because you're broke as f***, like, and like, we don't want to help you out anymore, and like, we're cutting you off soon. And I'm just like, oh my God, like, what am I going to do with my life? But I can't, you know, sell out to these guys, basically. I can't like sell my integrity.
Turning down that deal and turning down the money and the publicity that came along with that deal was a big feat because it was just me and Louis. We were all alone. We didn't have any money. We had full-time jobs, both of us. Like, I was teaching dance, Louis was teaching music at times. We were both like summer camp counselors. It was a lot of work.
Saying no to a couple record label deals we were offered, in which they did want to modify our aesthetic to what they saw best. It wasn't consistent with our vision. And saying no and walking away from those deals was like maybe the most important thing we did in that time period of living like the starving artist lifestyle.
How can I go? That's how it is. I mean, like, now we're really trying to stay true to ourselves, and I think it's easier because we went through situations like that where people were literally telling us to change and do something else, and it's like, now we kind of like know better who we are and what we want to do. And I don't know, I guess the good thing now is that people are just kind of like we have a really nice team around us who is supportive of who we are and what we want to do, and that makes a big difference.
We hate excuses. There's no excuses with us. We always find a way around the mountain, like, which is like why we have our wonderful manager too, because he doesn't take excuses too. We just like, we're not into that. Like you just figure out a way to get it done.
My main advice for people who are trying to do something like that, and actually advice that I give friends who have bands who are trying to do the same thing that we're doing, which is really exciting, is to really set out a list of goals for yourself. That's what we did. Louis and I would sit down frequently and do 5-month plans where it was like literally a 12-page Google Doc where we would say every single thing that we're gonna do in the next 5 months. It was like, we're gonna play a show. These are the possible venues we're gonna play with, and these are possible bands we wanna play with. And then we would book the show. And then we would be like, we want to record 6 new songs and release one in 4 months. And then we would do that. And then even for the release of a song, we were like, we want to release it and we want it to be premiered on these 5 blogs.
If you have to be patient and set on your hands, that's fine. But, you know, persistence, stay persistent. We were just really patient and persistent. That's kind of like been our, like one of our mottos is just like, You know, everything happens for a reason, but just like stay on it. You know, don't let anything slip through the cracks, or don't presume anyone's going to hand anything to you on a silver platter.
And we started doing that 3 years ago. And every time we would get to the end of the 5 months, we were like, oh my God, we did it. How the hell did we pull that together? And it's nice, it's gratifying, and it kind of like keeps you grounded, and also reminds you like, okay, you are making progress even though nobody's picking up your calls.